Zenith 25 MC36 repair part 2. Check out part 1. You'll see that the high voltage rectifier tube is not getting any filament voltage. And I've analyzed how this is assembled. And you can't remove this box off of here without removing the flyback. So what would have to happen to rewind the filament turns on the flyback would be the chassis has to be pulled out and the flyback has to be unbolted from the bottom of the chassis and then pulled out. And I've come up with another solution. I do like to always fix these sets back to their original condition, but in this particular instance, I'm going to go with something different. I ordered the wire, which you can see here, this red coil of wire is 40 kilovolt wire, which I would use to replace the filament winding on the flyback, because I'm pretty sure it's arcing through the winding to the core and grounding out. But also, when I called, they had a solid-state replacement high-voltage rectifier tube, which does not require the filament voltage. And what I've decided to do, because this set has so many hours on it and is so dirty and so brittle, all these wires and grommets are so brittle, is I'm just going to terminate the two blue filament wires. I'm doing this, clip them off of the socket, and stick the high voltage, solid state high voltage rectifier in there as a replacement. So here you can see my blue wires are just cut off, my filament leads, and I have the thing back together, the insulating cup and the high voltage, solid state high voltage rectifier, all installed, ready to close the cage up and try it out. Intimidating. It's all glowing blue. It appears the high voltage is much higher with the solid state rectifier, or the high voltage regulation's not working. This is kind of interesting that the picture is pulled in widthwise. There's a definite high voltage regulation problem here, because the can hear the hissing increase when I turn the high voltage down, or the brightness down, rather. Well, it's about 20. Where is it arcing now? It's about 28 kilovolts. That's the get in the kind of got leakage here everywhere. The high voltage, I am turning the damn high voltage. All I can say is that this TV is extremely angry with that solid state rectifier in it. It didn't have any of these problems before. And we have about a 1 inch, and I've never seen the camera blank out like this, but there's about 1 inch width deficiency now on both sides. I don't know what this the high voltage is just so damn high, it's driving everything nuts. I replaced the high voltage regulator tube and I can now control this at minimum brightness. I can hold it at about 27, and if I crank it up here, 35, it'd go right up to 38 kilovolts. You can hear the hissing there. This reduced size all the way around really interests me, why the conversion to a solid state rectifier would cause the horizontal to be shrunk in over 1 inch on each side and the vertical to be pulled up top and bottom. You can see the I don't know if it's overloading the flyback or what, and the color won't sync anymore. Color's all over the place. So I've connected my variac and lowered the line voltage down. And I can drop the line voltage down to about 80 volts and still get a picture until the filaments cool off. I've come up with a theory here, which is only a theory until I prove this, but my theory is that the high voltage solid state rectifier replacement is so much more effective and efficient and conductive than the tube that it's loading down the high voltage, loading down the flyback rather, and causing low drive to the yoke and low boost voltage, which is causing the vertical not to pull down and up as far. Once again, it's only a theory until I'm going to have to pull this apart and replace the winding and get the tube back in there, because this set worked really well before this, and now it has all kinds of deflection issues and color issues that just weren't here, and I haven't done anything to this except all that arcing, which hopefully didn't damage anything. Anyway, this will be part 2 of a 3-part video. Part 3 will definitely be tearing this thing apart to replace the high voltage filament winding on the flyback. Okay, part 2 and 3 are gonna go together. I pulled the chassis out here. This is more like changing a timing belt than working on a television set. It's very mechanically challenging. And I got to the 2 screws that hold the flyback in from the bottom. And right there are the 2 turns of blue wire around the bottom of the flyback, and surprisingly they are caked with cigarette juice, but they look okay. So I'm stumped. Anyway, I'm gonna replace them. Just get a wire cutter and cut them out of there and replace it with the new red wire. So here's the Two new turns of red 40 kilovolt wire. I don't see how this is going to fix it, but I'm just going to kind of stick it back together and test it. Okay, I have the set powered up with the new filament wire here. We have good high voltage. Talk about a dangerous situation. Everything is literally just hanging because I did not believe this would fix it. I'm going to hold this up here and show you the high voltage rectifier filament. You can see it glowing there, and we've got a little bit of arcage due to the everything just being open and kind of hanging in the air. And also, I would like to note that we have full deflection all the way around again. I'd also like to note that I have good color back again. So this set did not like that solid state rectifier substitute at all. Period. I want to talk about a cigarette deposit. This is the original high voltage rectifier, and this thing is actually juicy. This is a liquid coated resin nicotine tube. If this was pot smoke, I could put this thing on eBay and get good money for it. Okay, so we're all back together here. We got our new high voltage rectifier filament leads. I even put the nice juicy cigarette flavored rectifier tube back in there. And we got good high voltage. Gonna seal it all up, put it back together, and see what kind of picture we get. So we're all back together here. Very stable, back working the way it was. Full deflection on all four sides. Good color. Also, my high voltage is right on now, and I got good regulation here. I can basically go from about 32 kilovolts down to 20 kilovolts with my high voltage adjustment. I set it about 24, which is right about in the middle. This damn thing here sounds like a high tension line in the fog. There's still a lot of leakage there, but that's just due to all the cigarette deposit. There's not much I can do about that. I cleaned it up as best I can, and without replacing that, I don't think I can get it any better. Maybe soak it in some carb cleaner or something. Anyway, this thing's back working, looks good, ready to use. So after running for about 30 minutes, another problem appeared, which is I kind of lost high voltage here. Drive, anyway. If I crank the brightness up, it just totally blooms and goes out. So this will be, I guess, part two of a three-part video. This could be, it might just have a bad flyback after all. And it might be internally shorting when it warms up. I'm not sure. I'm going to have to do more diagnosis here.